Hello and welcome to my recording session, which is my live coding session of Project Job Manager. I implement here my frontend for this project. And yeah, last time I mentioned that I will work on the story to write implementation for validation of my registration formula. But before I will do that, I do some little brainstorming. So basically, the current situation like it is, I have my entity user. And I have Spring Boot. Spring Boot framework. Let me just do it here. Spring Boot framework. And the Spring Boot framework get and is accessed by the user. Actually, let me a little draw some stuff. So the user access Spring Boot framework. Spring Boot framework has a container, web container, not to think about Docker, because Docker it's like outside of all the application, and I'm not sure that I will use Docker at this point. Maybe later when I need to write integration tests. So basically here I have my web app, and it's currently looks like this, that this user class is coupled with my web app. Why? Because if user ask for registration, Spring Boot process this request, get hold of my controller, and controller make sure that all of the entities which are used in the formula get acquired. So the user gets as a response back and one form with the input fields. This is actually what user get. Now, after providing these fields and submit button, user need to type the information into the fields, and the fields must be verified. First of all, I do simple verification, which is like street name can only contain a string type of stuff, and date can only get hold of dates. And then I need to provide the stuff for the same kind of sake for the different kind of field. So if user type number into the field where I expect only string, it should fail. So the user cannot be registered. Another story is with additional verification. It is actually to make sure that I have a real user, not the bot. And this bot, the bot's wall will not be allowed. So using capture external framework, I probably will be able to make sure that nobody, no bots can be registered into my system. So, and the user clicks after all the data was validated, he clicks onto submit, and the data gets populated. back to the Spring Boot framework, and Spring Boot framework creates in the memory, because I do not use DB currently, we need to create user. We need to create a user, so that user can actually log in into the system. And this is kind of rough idea. Some people say, why don't you draw UML? And I say it would be too much work to draw an UML. But anyhow, this is my way of thinking. This is my way of explaining what I need to do. I know you can do it in the UML stuff, but I'm not kind of guy which prefer to use UML whenever it makes sense. I prefer to use UML only if I have some strange cohesion problems, strange coupling problems, strange interface segregation problems, things which really hard to maintain or to get clue what actually in which class populated which information. So this is what I say about. So next, I need to switch to Eclipse and show you my implemented validation of the form. So let's do that. Okay, so I took some time camera off because I have urgent things to do. I'm back. Okay, so yeah, it works, and let me just quickly switch to my I'm using always help from outside. I'm always using it. I cannot recall everything, but doesn't matter. So basically the story which I implement when a user input made a second, where is my stories? I think I need to log in. Let me try it. Okay. So, register new user in web platform. Simple story. User should provide following data: first name, last name, birth date, email, city, street, and such and such and such. Username, job state, blah blah blah, and so on. So, and how it will look? First of all, I have written a simple test like here. What this test actually does, it tries, it makes actually a post to the following path: submit new user registration and expect status is bad request. Why? Because if somebody tries to hack my stuff, he definitely would not use the form which I provide to the user. So let me, these two tests should pass, because I expect that if somebody just tries to request this method, the test will fail. I mean, he get bad request. Run as JUnit test. Alright. And you see, it did pass. Let me show you the output. I done the post, submit new user, and I got bad request. So that is what I expect to get, and the test did pass. Pretty cool. Okay, and now I have following in my stuff. Now I just need to actually show you my form. This is a form which I use to register the user, new member registration. And what happens? I have here this stuff, actually I will delete it, I don't need it, this was for debug purposes. So basically, if user requests my controller per get reg new user, he gets the form registration new user. If the user submit the data from the form, then it get through all of this request parameters. So basically, let me just run Let me actually always, I have set up manual build because it takes always CPU time, and I don't like when it's automatically builds without my, I need to stop the server. Let me just do it again. Project clean, clean the project, and then manually perform build stuff, build project. Okay, now I can run it as Spring Boot app. Okay, so now you see completely it is running. I make clear the output currently, and I need to load the site, register new user. So, and you see completed 200, I got 200, which means it's all right. All stuff was done perfectly, did perfectly. So, and I see this formula. So, Thomas Meyer, date, I don't know, 11/02/1948, email test@test.com. What I'm doing, I'm actually doing a manual test. This is one of the cases which I want to postpone it for the later development in my project, because I'm more interested in getting stuff, simple stuff first done, and try not to overtest the actual UI. But it need to be tested too. So basically the street should be the name, and you see I have no validation for the fields. I need to add, this will be the next story for the next coding live session, where I add validation for my input fields. So street, what should I have here? I don't know, Rotenburger. I like it, the name Rotenburger. Rotenburger 46. Country, of course, it is Germany, because I'm a German. Male, username A. Orlovsky. Job state, self-employed. And CAPTCHA. About CAPTCHA, it is another story. So this field I'm actually not getting, but because I need to understand how CAPTCHA works and how I can possibly integrate into my project, I just decided to do it later. So let's just hit this button, submit registration, and you clearly see the it was submitted. I got response, thank you for your registration. Pretty simple response. Later it will be like so, if user click on submit registration, he will land onto the first page, because I did not implement the first page, but I use kind of a mockup currently. It's okay. So let's just look at the output. So the output is like following. User first name Thomas, last name Maya. Here I have need to make sure my, wait a second. Yeah, it just output issue, because I did not edit the new line. So, but you clearly see all data is okay. Let me do some small adjustment. Where it was, normally I prefer to use just to string user city. I think I have user file name, user last name, email. Here we go. Here I need to put the line breaker. Now it's all right. So now I just need to once again project clean project, because I use an Eclipse STS version, and now I can actually run it, run a Spring Boot app, and now it runs okay. And you see clearly that's Spring Server running, and I can actually test my application. So yeah, it's kind of manual test, but this is kind of things which I want to automate later during the project. So you see, basically my way of thinking, I'm doing slice testing, I'm testing my controller, and I did make sure that my static directories are accessible, where I will put my CSS, where I might put my JavaScript and my IMG. So let's just test my stuff. Alex, then I put some dates, 12/78, doesn't matter. Email, like, I don't know. cooldeveloper@home.com. City Nuremberg. Street is Rotenburger. I'd like just Rotenburger, and 6046. Germany. Mail, username Aorowski. Okay, and now I just need to put here self-employed. I'm a freelancer. So submit registration, and you see the message, thank you for your registration, and you see basically the response from the server. Pretty simple. Yep, I provided all the data. Alex, exactly what I put it, this is what I got. So basically it goes like this. Now I have established further development. I have written not so many tests, but still I just need to get basic functionality first. And I will do testing further. I will later in the next session, when I am done with my validation, I need to make sure to write somehow a validation test for the view, for the validation that I can actually input the data to the view. So basically that's it. I can actually close all done, run my test suite. And when it runs, then I can deploy to commit to S4N. And this is what I basically expect from people who professionally develop some stuff. Surely I have I should think about validation, and I will do the validation work, and I will do my best to make sure that all input fields are validated. Another thing will be with the capture, because the capture, this is external service or tool or framework, I don't know, I need to look it up how it works and understand what kind of things I can expect from this capture tool. And you see, basically build success, and I can actually deploy it. I need to make just to make sure that I have clean it, run as clean, Maven clean. Always clean your project, because you don't need to commit unnecessary stuff. Build success, and then I just need to make project clean for the Eclipse sake. Okay, and then I do team commit. Now I just need to look at what did changes. I definitely work with the controller. Controller test, req user HTML. Need to add some stuff. Application Java. Okay. So, application Java probably nothing. I did nothing, changed nothing there. Let's just add it to new user, add the confirmation. So, written test for checking if post if new addition. So let's always think about meaningful commits messages. So I have written a test. Test for add new user and add new confirmation HTML page. That's it. Commit and push. So that's it. Basically, the next probable step. Where it is? Ah, here. So now I need to be. Let me pinpoint what I will do the next story. The next story will be definitely need to update the site, validate input fields from the registration form. So you see clearly what this is what I expect to have. I need to make sure that all stuff is valid, and when it's valid, then it can be tested. And basically, maybe I will definitely do still manual test, because I think to add a captcha. I need to add the captcha, and my basic idea is the following. User, so here's the form. Form user provides the input to the form, and this form need to be verified. If the fields are verified, it means valid input. If the input is valid, then I need to make sure that the person who typed all the stuff is not a bot, not an AI. So a captcha will appear, and the captcha will say, okay, I am checking if the person who are making sure that is working is a real person. And this will basically, I will say, kind of manual test. But what I can actually automate, I can actually make sure that the data which user provide is valid. And after the captcha says ok, so basically it looks like this. Valid fields, valid captcha, it all must be true, and when I have all the validation done, I need to make sure that if all data is correct, I need to make sure for some kind of things like does this user disabled, I mean, like, maybe does this user already in the system? Does this user disabled? And yeah, I cannot think right now any other cases, but probably definitely will think about that. But all the data, when it's validated, it will be submitted to some kind of pool of data collection. I don't know, because I do not wish to work with database at this time on point. So I will do it like this, and definitely it make a lot of fun. And thank you for your time. That's it.